Hi everybody, I wish you a warm welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We are on the way to discover how to launch and play The Legend of Neverland on your PC. Now you are displaying it on screen. We will be able to simply download and install The Legend of Neverland so that we can enjoy playing this game on our Windows computer using our keyboard, mouse and big screen. So it's time to have fun, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, to get started we need to launch our main browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to this URL that I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type anything, simply because I provided a link in the description of this video and the first main comment. We ended up there on our site of Usitility, at which we include an in-depth demonstration on how you can download and install The Legend of Neverland on personal computer. We search lower a bit and mouse click on the download game on PC button. After clicking on this link, we get to the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will launch to enjoy the game The Legend of Neverland on PC. It is now obvious that we have a number of advantages of preferring using the emulator. So we are ready to proceed to download The Legend of Neverland by simply clicking on this button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. The step is clicking on it. Of course, the download step starts and ends immediately. Voila! Here is located the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to launch the executable file, so we have to click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the laptop or device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to view the installation software considerably better. The installation software is straightforward. It includes a couple of possibilities, install and setup path. I will talk about what setup path genuinely does. We basically simply click on it. And so we note that we get here the path where the emulator can be placed. If we have to change for better this directory, we are required to click on that browse button, and we choose another folder and install the emulator specifically where we like. I will leave it as it is. I simply click back. Therefore I just click install. Fantastic. The setup starts and it is going to progress along with the download of all these MB that are shown on this screen. Once you download it, it might possibly be a little bit more or less MB. The data transfer rate could go faster or slower, determined by your internet and depending on the performance of the emulator hosting servers. Today they're going quite fast. The download is done, then at this point it continues on with the setup part. The setup requires more or less time primarily based on the strength of your computer. The more powerful it is, the faster the installation time and or vice versa. If we add together the download and install phase, it usually takes a considerably long time, so be patient. It has by now completely finished for me. At this time, the emulator happens to be launched on autopilot. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar which will fill up then when it comes to the ending, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. The fact is that the emulator has been launched, there for the very first time. Before we keep going, as you will notice, it made a couple of app icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon will be the only one we're considering. Anytime we are planning to start The Legend of Neverland on our laptop or computer, we twice click the software icon and therefore launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance app icon isn't about multiplayer or even nearly anything such as that. Of course, it is a software icon that we might most likely never make use of. Let me conduct the next step, which is actually a must-have, and which is to begin to browse the Google Play Store. As you understand, the Google Play is started. There we have got to log on. Currently, once we are on this page, we must absolutely conduct this next phase, which is absolutely mandatory. So that we click on sign in. At present it shows checking info. It may occasionally get stopped at checking info, additionally it fails to continue. In this case, you may try to connect to your account after a number of hours and it will surely most probably be sorted out. At present we're going to type in our email and password. The email address is required to be a Gmail email and its associated password. As an example, you may use the same email you're using at this time in your own YouTube account. Then I will enter my information and I'll come back when I have completed it. Voila! Info inserted. Find out Google welcoming us and presenting us their twos. We must agree to them all by simply clicking on, I agree. Then, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also keep it selected and this will generate a backup of your data files on this device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you can make use of this option if you prefer. We mouse click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is started by default and on autopilot. To set up the video game, we are required to get to the emulator desktop by double-clicking on the icon marked in green. At this point that we are discovering the desktop of the emulator for Android, we can see that we have now there the install app game button. We click or double-click on this button. On this page we have got the video game. How about we mouse click right here on the install choice that I'm just displaying now in green color. This action will commence the setup. Presently it is going to download on your laptop or computer and set up the Android game. It usually takes a bit of time, or perhaps it could be very fast. It all varies on our internet access. This has as of now finished installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by clicking that option I'm showing in green, that allows you to use the Legend of Neverland for the first time. We should simply click on the My Games choice just above. You are now on the emulator desktop, and consequently we are on the way to simply click the fresh The Legend of Neverland icon which was provided. Your game app is launched for the very first time. Here we end up with it. I can also mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to discuss the volume of that emulator. This is right here. We use the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This way we don't count on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the max, we will activate the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This one is actually the first one. We mouse click on that app icon which I am mentioning in green color. Thus the monitor is maximized, getting one border on top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. If ever we would like to experience the application using all the screen, we click that software icon. And as a result we would likely by now be experiencing and enjoying the gameplay in 100% screen function. To stop the full screen functionality, hit the F11 key. And we'd by now play in standard display setting. At this point, I am choosing to present you the computer keys mapping, and that is definitely rather useful. This step we will probably be able to use the game far more easily. The first task is to mouse click this keyboard icon. It's now time to make the recommended setups. I can let the normal configuration, though if you really want to change it, you can do this without any problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is entirely in our language. On occasion it occurs that your emulator is presented in the erroneous language, as an example, in Mandarin. And so to place it in the correct language we click here to the cogwheel. And thus there within many other configuration settings, we click the language drop down. We will determine the language we like, German, Mandarin, etc. Once the language is chosen, we are going to save, the emulator would reboot, as well as the game app. The next time we run it, will also be in the opted for language. Presently, you can find another aspect that we have to take into consideration, and this is that we will get an email indicating that a different equipment has been connected to our Google account. It should check with us if we are the individuals who have associated with that electronic device. Yes, we must not be troubled, because the emulator is simulating an Android tablet or smartphone. And in order to find which electronic device is currently being emulated, we visit right here, to the cogwheel, and we then click on it. Be sure you browse here to the model option. And now we realize that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for this video user demo. I hope that you appreciated it, especially that everyone found it interesting. If that's so, give it a good like, subscribe to my channel, and any feedback, requests or ideas, leave them in the comment field down below. You can also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams ever so often, you have it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click on any of those online videos that are appearing on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the next training videos. Bye.